Hello friends, today we are going to see the computerized numerical control machine, which is also called as a CNC, in which we will cover the introduction to CNC, features of CNC machine and components of CNC machine. So first we'll go for the introduction of CNC machine. In CNC machine, computer numerical control machine, dedicated computer is used to perform the most of the basic NC machine functions like spindle of the machine tool or drive motors, or I can say the table movements. So if you see on the screen, whatever the programs we are written through the keyboard on the computer, right, that has been sent to the machine control unit. This is a machine control unit here. And then this has been transferred to the machine tools, means NC machine tool. So in NC machine tools, there are different movements will take place. That is a movement of the table, right? In the X axis, Y axis, or Z axis for the cutting tool. And spindle movements are there. And along with that, we are giving the movements to the spindle, that is a spindle drive along the clockwise or anti-clockwise. So all this process will be taken place in the CNC machine. Now the entire program is entered and stored in the computer memory. CNC machines are programmed using a set of commands, which is known as a G command or G code or a M code. And G code and M code is nothing but G code is basically a preparatory function code. M code is a miscellaneous function. In G code, it will direct the CNC machine to process the coordinate data in a particular manner. Means if you want, various functions will be done, like a spindle rotate in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. We are giving the feed rate, right? Then the table movement along the XY plane or YZ plane, ZX. So as I said, a number of commands will be given in the G code to the machine control unit, through the machine control unit, and then the machine will operate. And in the M code, means that is a miscellaneous function, various functions which will be done, that is a spindle start, stop, then the program start, program end, or program stop, tool change, etc. There are again, so that type of miscellaneous functions can be done in the M code. Now the program which is stored in a computer can be used for the further production also. Means repeatedly we can use, because program is already stored in the computer, and with respect to that the job will be again produced. So this is how, just the introductory part of the CNC. You can see this is the what the code we are using. You can see on your screen here, we are using the G codes there. Even you can use the M codes also. So different codes we can use. This is the M code you can see here. This is also the M code. So like that, the programs has been done. Then the features of CNC machine. So first feature is that the part program can be fed to the control unit through the keyboard, you can see. So for that, naturally the keyboard is there, that keyboard is directly on the machine also. Okay, through that we can write the program, and which is you want to feed to the control unit, that is a machine control unit. Second function or feature of that, the part program once entered can be used again and again, and that's why CNC control is termed as a soft wire control. As we know that in the CNC machine, the memory, already the memory is there, right? We can store the program in that memory and you can use again and again. And that's why it is also called as a soft wire control. Then the third is that the part programs can be edited whenever required. So here I have just shown that if you are writing the program there, right, on the computer screen, you can easily edit it fourth feature is for common and repetitive operation of subprogram can be created and called in a main program whenever required. As many time we can see same operations we are performing on other jobs also. So if the same operation is performed, which we can already stored in the memory of the computer, and then we can reuse in the main program. Means suppose we are writing this as a main program, and we can use the G code command for entering that program in the main program, and then you can easily means we can whatever the time is taken will be very less to write, because only you have to call that program in the main program. So yahan hamara time bhi bach jata hai. That's what features of the CNC machine. Then fifth feature of the CNC machine. The CNC machine have a simulation facility whereby the part program can be checked for its accuracy without actually running the machine. So means if you want to check the accuracy without running, it's possible without running the machine. You can see in the screen here, we are just holding the computer in the chuck, and in the I have shown this on the computer, means I can observe it on the computer without running the machine. Suppose I want to do the facing operation, yes, I can check it on the computer itself. Then we can go for the taper turning operations, different operations we have performed. Means without running the machine, right, you can check the program and how we can generating the shape or the material can be easily. Now, this is the biggest advantage of the CNC machines. Then the CNC control unit allow compensation for any change in the dimension of the cutting tool caused due to wear. So due to the continuous use, many times the cutter may get wear out. So in that case, if you replace it other one, then it will be automatically get compensation. So for that you can use the G code. So the cutter diameter compensation cancel, or G41, that cutter diameter compensation left, G42 cutter compensation right. So like that, the if you give the command, automatically it will, the cutter will adjust, and the will get a perfect component as per the drawing. So these are the six major features of the CNC machine. Then the components of the CNC machine. Our first component is the input output device. Second will be the microprocessor bus control unit, means MCU control, machine control unit which you are using. But here we say microprocessor bus control unit can mostly we are using in the machines. Then memory, two memories you are using, RAM and ROM memory. Then third, feedback units. So for that you can use the linear transducer or encoders are also there. Then the machine tool, then the interface components of CNC machine. In that, now we'll go in more details. So first is the input output device. It is a unit through which the part program is fed to the CNC tool system and required output is taken out. So it is basically consist of a monitor and a keyboard, right? And a monitor may be a CRT or a LED, and which is used to indicate the current status of the program as it been executed. Then the second one is the machine control unit. In that, the microprocessor which we are using here, so this controller will takes the input from the input output device, right, even the feedback from the feedback units, and also actuate the various drives there, as well as the tool of the machine tool, that is a spindle or a table or a motor drive, etc. So here again, there are, we are using the memory. There are two type of memory we are using. One is the RAM memory. RAM is nothing but the random access memory, and other one is the ROM memory, which is called as a read only memory. So in the RAM, the NC part program are stored in the RAM devices. Okay. And the current program in the RAM can be erased. Means whatever we are writing the programs, you can easily erase and we can replace it by the new program as the jobs are changed. So according to the whatever the jobs you have to perform, with respect to that, you can write the new programs there in there. So here, this we are writing the program or set giving the set of instructions to by using the M code and G codes there. Then the as we see in the ROM, here the control program for the machine tools, basically when we are giving the movements in the X slide or a Y slide or a Z. So for that, we are using the read only memory machine control unit or machine control tools. So in this, machine tool is operated by the control unit. The machine tool receives the signal now from the machine control unit, that is through the microprocessor, and the signals are understood by the machine spindle, table, and other parts like I can see the motors and controls there. So here, whatever the we can see in this diagram, the control unit means is just giving the signals to the various parts of that machine. We are giving to the spindle also, we are giving the moment to the table also, or some other drives also. Then the feedback unit is there, and in this feedback unit, it takes the input from the machine tool, right, and it transfers to the control unit, that is the machine control unit, for the necessary corrections. If there is anything goes wrong, okay, by writing the program, right, in that case we can edit the programs, and the microprocessor again we can change it through the input output device is there, right? So after making the corrections, again the process will run, and the again the control unit will give the feedback, give the movement to the various drives, and again job will be performed. So in this way, the here basically the I'm showing the closed loop system, because whatever is wrong in the program, it may get corrected, right? So that is called as actually the feedback unit. Thank you, friend.